Oh my fucking god, dude. What did we just find on day one? Alright, yo, what the fuck is up, Buttercups? It's your boy Hates, or Hatesville here today, and welcome to the first episode of our brand new Alpha 18 7 Days to Die Let's Play. So keep in mind, guys, I'm actually coming fresh from console, so I haven't seen any of the new updates or much to do at all with Alpha 18, so this is gonna be brand new, like brand fucking new. I actually have no clue what I'm doing right now. So yeah, I'm trying to keep this as a entertaining experience as possible, so make sure to leave some comments below on some things you guys would like to see. I'm trying to keep this series fan interactive, meaning you guys are gonna be able to actually decide what I go out and do in these episodes or what I build, and so on. So yeah, so right now we're basically just trying to get these quests done. We're collecting stuff off the ground there. We might head over towards that city, but I think I'm gonna head towards this house right here because I feel like it's gonna be less of a point of interest for zombies and everything like that. So yeah, I might actually cut the video to when I have all these quests done, but let's go ahead and do that there now. Actually, let's go ahead and craft this bedroll. That's done. Alrighty, we just gotta place this down here real quick. Bam. Craft the stone axe. I hate the stone axes. I think I just heard a spider zombie, guys, but I might be tripping because I don't know the sounds in this new update because they're a lot different from the console version, but I definitely see a crawler there for one, so I know that. I think I just seen a shadow as well. Yep, just seen a shadow. Oh my god, dude, we got a fucking vulture. This is not the start at all that we wanted. Let's see if we can get these crafted quickly enough so that we can get the club crafted and maybe a spear. Oh my, I thought he was coming for me just then. Alright, let's wear these. Jesus Christ, dude. That vulture is really going to be a problem. The crawler's not the problem here, guys. The vulture actually is. So I'm going to go ahead and craft this wooden club and actually make a spear. The stone spear is my favorite weapon in the game right now because it's new, it's refreshing. And actually, the stone spear isn't the steel spear is, but, you know, just using a spear, being able to throw it and actually able to hit your enemies at a decent distance is a lot different from the console version. So I'm loving this. I really want to kill this thing, though, man. It's making me fucking nervous. Leave a comment below and let me know what you guys are actually doing during your guys' quarantine. I'm basically just living out an apocalypse in an apocalypse, pretty much, so I really want to get rid of that thing, though, guys. It's fucking annoying. Let's kill that thing. Oh, we got our first zombie, guys. 6 feet? 6 feet? You better stay 6 feet away, motherfucker. I don't want what you got. You guys, if you guys noticed, like, if you were that close, what I just did there on console, you'd be able to hit him, but where I was farther back, you would not be able to hit him that far back on console, and they can actually hit you from a little bit farther away, and they do a lot more damage. I'll show you guys an example here now. Look at that. Oh, he actually made me bleed out first hit. What the fuck? So yeah, they pack a lot more damage, guys. But I think what we're gonna do right now is actually go ahead and move this house over towards here and make this our base for the night. This place right here. There should be a door down here in the basement area that's unlocked so that we can get up into the houses, but I'm willing to bet that it's actually overrun by fucking those sleeping zombies. We didn't have that on console, and we still don't because console hasn't been updated in fucking years, but yeah, there's actually zombies that, they're technically like asleep until you make a noise that wakes them up, so hopefully I can show you a good example of it here now. I'm willing to bet there's like one or two in this room. So we got one right there.
Watch out!
Jesus Christ. What the fuck? Not gonna lie, that kind of scared the shit out of me. Jesus, he popped out of nowhere, dude. Holy fuck, how many hits is this dude gonna take? Dude, I swear to God, I'm fighting Mike Tyson right now. Jesus. Honestly, I think the safest route would be to craft some bow and arrows, so yeah, let's go ahead and do that. We can craft four arrows, craft a couple bows here. Let's craft one bow, and let's go ahead and get these arrows crafted so we can go ahead and deal with the rest of the zombies, because I do believe it's the most efficient way for sneaking around. They can't really hear you if you're, shoot them from a distance. So yeah, let's go ahead and sort out our inventory here and then make our way. We're gonna want to be careful approaching here because we know for a fact that there is another sleeping zombie just ahead of us, behind us here. So yeah, let's go ahead and actually take her out right now, just like this. What's up, bitch? Another one down. We probably got about like 15 to go in this house, but that's all right let's see if we can get our arrow back here. I don't think we're gonna be actually lucky enough. Normally you can actually recollect your stone arrows when you shoot them, like even if it's at a wall or at a zombie, but sometimes they break. This kind of looks like this door leads to outside, but I don't think so because I see some bars there, so we'll come back to that door anyways. We'll come back. For now, let's go ahead and clear the zombies. Hello? Good day, sir. And a good night, sir. Anyone else? The motherfucker didn't stand a chance. Alright, let's remember that. There's something under that floorboard there. I love the way they updated the loot in this game, guys. You can loot, like, anywhere. They hide it so well in this game. I'll show you guys some examples. So this actually looks like the door that we were talking about that leads outside, which I thought that it didn't after. So, yeah, I was right about that. But, yeah, they hide the loot so well in this game now, guys. You can find it in the floors, behind cabinets, behind paintings. I'll show you guys some examples. But for now, we're going to go ahead and make sure that we're going to get rid of any threats, any upcoming threats that we see. So, yeah, I'm willing to bet there's some motherfucker out right here. Oh, Jesus Christ, dude. Why is he standing up? I always wondered that. But as you can see here, guys, we can actually collect this stone arrow. And I believe there's another bitch right here just chilling. What's up, bitch? Bam! Gone like the wind, motherfucker. Let's see if we can collect that back. Yep. We're getting lucky being able to pick these arrows back up because we really don't have fuck all. Oh my. Look at this. Holy shit, dude. I don't think we'll be getting that arrow back. Her head just fucking exploded. But look at this, guys. This is a prime example of how good they hide the loot. Look at that behind the wall there. Kind of wish they hid the loot that well in the console version of the game, but what can you do, man? The way they updated this for PC, you guys, is actually insane. And I really do feel like once you do what you want to do on console, it's pretty much it. But this feels limitless, this game. Which is so sick. I see who's waiting for me at the top, motherfuckers, man. They scattered the zombies throughout the houses in this perfectly, guys. There's like the perfect amount of zombies. I actually fucking hate taking the stealth route when it comes to looting houses because it just takes so much more longer than it normally would. This is normally how I go about waking the zombies up and looting the house in 7 days. Where's the fuck? Get the fuck out! Give it to me, I'm on the get no sleep cause of y'all! Y'all not gonna get no sleep cause of me! I feel like that's a pretty accurate representation. I got a feeling like there's gonna be no zombies down here in the bottom part, but I feel like there's gonna be some up towards the attic, so let's go ahead and check this out and see what we can find up here. I got a feeling like I'm gonna turn around, there's gonna be one waiting for me right behind me. Oh no. Surprise, surprised. Wow. There's actually no zombies in the attic. I don't think I've ever seen that before in place. So this looks like it's gonna be our main point of interest to loot. Alrighty, fuck it. I think that we've cleared out most of them. So I think now it should be alright to actually go in and go full threat mode. Wake a couple of these motherfuckers up. Sup, bitch? How'd that taste, motherfucker? Stay 6 feet back, bitch. Feels like there's like two or three in this room. Yeah, here we go. They're starting to pop out there now. Man, on console, you guys wouldn't even be able to hit them from this far away. It feels so sick to be actually able to hit them from a distance. You guys have no idea. I feel like I'm pretty knowledgeable when it comes to the console version of 7 Days, but I have a lot to learn yet from this update, guys. So yeah, we're in for a ride. So I'm hoping I'm making it as entertaining as possible. Let's kill this last dude. Here we go. So yeah, I'm hoping I'm making it as entertaining as possible. Anyone else in here want a party? I just thought that was a workbench. I'm a fucking idiot. But it looks like we're starting to clear. Is anyone else in my house, motherfuckers? It's time to get out, bitch. It's time to get out. Alright, these last two rooms are clear. I think we might actually be good to go ahead and loot here. Yeah, let's go ahead and start looting. Let's try and find a spot where we can actually place our bedroll first. Maybe in here would be better. Yeah, this back corner is actually perfect for it. We're gonna place it right here, guys. Alright, fuck it. Let's start looting. Give me the loot, boys. Give me the loot. We're gonna start in the basement area where we came in from. Let's craft around that about 12 frames here and go ahead and block off this entryway up ahead. Come on. Alright, we should be good. I think we're gonna make this our main entryway, so our main way that we get in and out of our base. So yeah, let's go ahead and make this a little bit fancy. I think right now we're just gonna block it off actually and then go ahead and start looting because I said I was gonna loot like eons ago. I just gotta break this little bit of paper off the ground. Then we're gonna turn around and go ahead and start looting here. So yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and start looting here. I think I'm gonna get this mound of trash right here first. What do we got? Some coins, some scrap polymers. I'll take that. This gas barrel. You used to be able to just pick these up in console, man, back in the good old days. Anything else in this room? Doesn't look like it. Alrighty, I think we'll head on to the next room. Oh, I think we've got a hunting bag up here. Or a sports bag, rather. I found some water. Not too bad. Not too bad. What do we got in here? We got some cupboards we can search. Oh, we just found a fucking wrench. Let's go. Some water. That wrench is going to come really in handy, guys. That's actually sick find for day one. Got some money, some nails. I actually keep that money to sell the trader because it's worth a nice bit. Take that cloth for some bandages. Scrap both of that. I always scrap the items that I can scrap right away for tin or iron. Just like the cans. I never keep the cans. I think that's it for this room. Let's go ahead and see what we can find in here. Nothing in there. Alright, so I remember there's something in under the floor here, so let's craft a wooden frame so we can replace this right away. We got a small ammo pile. Let's see what we got. 13 pistol bullets. I will gladly take that. Let's go ahead and replace that frame there, actually, in this bathroom here. So, yeah. Let's see what we can find in here. Let's search the sink. Oh, corn on the cob. We found our first schematic here, our first recipe, rather. We got some lead. Had a trash bin. Some gunpowder. Great, great. I wonder if they still keep pistols in the toilet. That was pretty OP on console. Found some murky water there. Oh, beaker. Grain alcohol. Not bad, not bad. Oh, look, dude, we got a vending machine here. What the fuck? Having a vending machine in the base is actually pretty OP. That means we're not going to run out of food anytime soon, so that's fucking sick. What's in this trash? Just trash, nothing. Sweet fuck all. Let's go ahead and see what's up in here. These zombies are actually kind of getting really annoying. It's making it really hard to talk when all I'm hearing is fucking screaming. I think we might actually go ahead and just actually take care of these zombies here. Yeah, fuck it. You know what? We're going to go out through the basement way, and we're going to go ahead and take care of these zombies. So, yeah. Fuck that. Oh, we can just barely squeeze out through a doorway, so at least we know that works. Let's go find these motherfuckers. Oh, I just can't wait to shut this motherfucker up. Man, if that was the only zombie here, I swear to fuck, that was the loudest zombie in the fucking game. Jesus Christ. There has to be more than that. Yeah, that's what I thought. I figured that. The fuck are you doing? Shut the fuck up. Thank you. Alright, let's go ahead and keep looting. Let's go ahead and see what we can find here in this trash. Oh, some glue and some duct tape. I'll take that. So we got a curved shape back in. We're gonna have to remember that. Alrighty. Let's head back up. Should I make a drop-off chest before I actually start looting? I feel like I'd be smarter because we don't have a lot of inventory space left at the moment. I just need to go ahead and gather some wood here. I think that, yeah, that's gonna give me one piece, so that's fuck all. Let's head out here and actually get some more wood. Because it's something different to do for the episode anyway, so we're not stuck in the house all the time. Thank God we got a lot of these little shrubs around. In the desert here, there's not a lot of trees, so... Oh, of course my fucking axe would break. Alrighty, now I gotta find some stone. Fuck's sake. Oh my, what the fuck is that? What is that? That is way too small to be a fucking wolf, dude. Holy shit, alright, let's craft this bandage. Bleed note twice in the first day, this is not a good start. What is that? If anyone in the comments can let me know what the fuck I just killed. Please. Thank you. Alright, I'm gonna cut the video when we get this fucking axe back and going. Alright, we got our chest place. Let's go ahead and actually drop a couple of these items off. We're gonna wanna keep a couple inventory spaces, actually a lot of inventory space open, because we still have a lot of loot to go through this house, I feel like it. So yeah, don't worry about this, guys. I actually haven't organized my chest, because I'm just gonna go ahead and hit that backpack button up on top, and it's all gonna sort nice and easy for me. So yeah, I'll show you guys exactly what I mean here now. And just like that, it's going to organize it nice and easy for me, as you guys can see. So I'm just going to go ahead and drop everything else off here, and then we're going to go ahead and go back to looting. I think for the first time in me ever playing 7 Days, I'm actually going to place a land block. I've never actually claimed any bit of land on 7 Days because I never knew the purpose of it. I've always just scrapped it for the free iron, so yeah, hopefully that does something. So yeah, let's go ahead and get back to looting. If I remember correctly, we already looted all this, so let's go ahead and head back upstairs. Here we go. Let's see what we can find. So yeah, I'll show you again here, guys. I always break the stuff that's on the walls, especially these paintings here, like this one right here on the wall here. Unfortunately, nothing's behind it. Maybe I can get... There we go, perfect example. Okay, so nothing's actually behind it, but as you guys can see, there's also something under it there as well. So this is just prime examples of how good they hide the loot in the houses, guys. So you guys are always going to want to be breaking the paintings. That's just a really quick tip. I don't think there's anything else to actually loot in these two areas right now, but unless we go up, so I think we're going to actually head back and loot these first. Let's see what we're getting here. Oh, we got another wrench. Thank fuck, we found a jar as well. Found some pills. see what we're getting here. Ooh, a splint, some more grain, alcohol. I like that. Get a pistol, come on. Nah, like I said before, I actually don't know if they still spawn pistols or even human turds in the toilet system, so I don't know. But hopefully one of these days we'll figure it out. Everything in here has been looted, if I remember. Let's go in here. Looks like... Oh, yep. See, look at that, guys. You never know until you look. Some more pistol ammo. That's going to go ahead and pile up nicely, actually. Small food pile. Some can of salmon. I'll take that. Canned Sam. Short iron pipe. I was going to scrap it, but we'll take it now, just in case we do find a forged schematic. I normally scrap the empty cans because I never use them, and they just give off free iron. So, some more glue here. Oh, I didn't realize you can search a trash compactor now. That's cool. That's actually really cool. Some more glue. Oh, cooking pot. I was hoping we were going to find one, actually. Some more cans we can scrap. I think I might just go ahead and let them build up my inventory and then scrap them before we go ahead and drop it off in our chest. I think that's going to lead to outdoors. Yep, I was right. Alrighty, let's see what else we can do here. So we looted all this. All that area was looted. I think the only thing we can do now is head up. Just want to check the floors again real quick. Nothing in the trash. What about this one? Some more pills. Not too bad, not too bad. So this is where we cleared out that massive amount of zombies. Not a massive amount. Oh, is that a padded hood? Let's go. We found a padded hood, dude, first day. So we got some armor here. Let's go ahead and wear that. I think I just dropped it. Jesus Christ. Alright, let's go ahead and wear that. Is that all we can search in this room? Oh, no, we missed a trash bin. Okay, we could have missed it. And look at that, guys. Just like that. Look how good they hide the fucking loot in this game. 5 glue behind the dresser. You guys really want to make sure you check every little inch of the rooms, man. It's actually crazy where they can stock the loot to. Some feathers. I don't know if you guys should break those long glass panes. I haven't found anything behind them, but it makes sense, so. Anything in here? Let's try it one more time. No. Search this bin. Fuck all in the bins. I only have the loot abundance on 100, by the way. But as you guys can see, they're pretty sneaky, man. They're pretty sneaky. If you don't catch it, if you don't catch it right off the bat, you won't. Oh, I had to repair the spear. Okay. What do I need to repair it? Small stone and plant fibers. Alrighty. That shouldn't be too hard to gather. Let's go see what we can find in here first. Oh, padded chest armor. Let's fucking go. That's gonna help us a lot. And I believe that's it for this room. I doubt there's gonna be much down here just because there's so much to loot. We've seen those two crates and the chest upstairs, so yeah. I would say let's go ahead and... This is probably our safest bet to go ahead and start looting that. Let's make our way up here slowly just in case we missed any zombies, even though we're using a broken spear. I think we're gonna check the weapons bag here first. Oh, we just found 2 junk turrets, dude. That is actually a sick find. I think the ammo actually only takes iron if I... We just found an AK. And another junk turret. Oh my fuck, dude. Are you kidding? What the fuck did we just find? Look at that, guys. On day one? You're fucking kidding me, dude. That is actually insane. I'm so hyped right now, guys. Leave a like for that. Some shotgun ammo, serrated blade mod. Alright, let's go ahead and crack these chests open. I think I said craft just then. Crack these chests open. What do we got? Shotgun parts. Give me something good. Oh, some more ammo. I will take more ammo for the AK. And we got a shamway. For some more food. What do we got in here? Come on. Look away for good luck like 9 times. You know what? We'll take them. We'll take them. They used to be green on console, so they look a lot better. Where do I hear this zombie? What the fuck? Alright. Alright, we might get our first kill with the AK here. I don't know where the fuck he just came from, but... I think we might as well. We're hitting the wood here. We're just gonna break. There we go. Look how powerful that AK is. Look at that. What a fucking fun for day one. Holy shit. Alright, is that all the loot? I think we looted every place in the house here, guys. That's fucking sick. Yeah, this is all the places that we can loot, guys. Holy fuck. Alright, let's go see what we got. Might as well pick up these chairs and scrap them for a bit of free wood instead of having to go out like every 10 seconds to get some. So, I actually thought we were gonna get a lot more than that, to be honest, but we're also gonna go ahead and fortify the base here too, guys. So I think what I'm gonna do is I might cut the video here and come back to when I had the base actually fortified and patched up to where I want to have it. So, well, looks like we found where they broke in. Jesus Christ. Alright, that would have been bad if we kept that open. Let's go ahead and repair this. We got a crawler at the door, guys. I'll show you guys a quick tip here, actually. If you don't want to break your door, what you can do is you can break the block above it and put a frame or two, depending on how high it is up. And if this dude went to a crawler, I'd be able to see his head and his arms, and I'd be able to hit him. I'll actually roll a clip of how I do it. Got it. Alright, I can't wait anymore. Come the fuck on, come on. Look at that, dude. Just with that AK, dude. Just like that, we need some more wood to craft a door. I'm willing to bet. Oh no. We can actually craft something this time. Oh, his fucking hand is in the way. Oh my god. Alright, we're gonna have to wait till he despawns. I don't know what I was just into there. I think I was just into some kind of configs or something, but whatever the fuck that was. Come on, despawn, dude. There we go. Thank you. We can finally place this fucking door down. It can be upgraded a little bit. There we go. Alrighty. Now we can come and go as we please. We have to work on the basement one too as well. Redwood again, so we'll just very subtly block off the back entrance here, just like that, quick and easy. And then let's go ahead and get some more wood and try and work on the main entranceway. It's kind of actually starting to look like a base when you walk out through here, so I'm gonna keep this downstairs area definitely as our main base area. For right now, what I think I'm gonna do, where I have so many frames right now, I think I'm just gonna get rid of this garbage pile here and start working on the other entranceway. So I'm not sure what we're going to do here. We might connect them all the way together, but for right now, I think I'm just going to actually shape out the first bit here and see what we can do from there. So I don't actually know if I take away these two, with the middle... Yeah, the middle one falls. So that idea is not going to work out, but what we can do is just place one here and one above it. How does that look? All right, we're getting somewhere with it. We're getting somewhere. So now we gotta try and figure out a way to connect it in here. This light is gonna be the problem, and I'll show you guys here why this light is a problem. You place it there, it's gonna fall. So I think we're gonna have to go one above it. And then, oh, fuck me. Are we really out of frames right now? Okay, so we might have to go ahead and get some more wood here, and I'm gonna cut back to when we're coming back to it. Anything in here? Alright, we got enough wood to make the extra frames here now. We do need to make the doors too, but we might as well make the frames first. Let's make 8. Actually, I think we should make more, but that should do for now. One up. And again, that's why it wasn't working. And there we go. And now we just connect it from the top. And let's connect it on the sides as well. Bit more. I knew we were gonna have to craft some more. There we go. Should we connect it on the bottom as well? Alright, let's head out here, actually grab a little bit more wood, and let's see what we can do here. Let's fuck up this tree real quick. Our first tree. That's pretty bad. Jesus, look at the time already. starting to clock down. I think what we'll do here now is craft a quick couple doors. And then we're going to upgrade the frames around here. And we'll get a final product for you guys here. I don't think we're actually going to be able to make it to the city this episode, though, guys. Because we already spent way too much time here at this. So let's go ahead and place the door. I want to right here. Yeah. Place the door there. Can we do it? Yep. That works out perfect. Alrighty, let's go ahead and replace that frame. And place this door here. Alrighty, now we're starting to get somewhere. So what I think I might do now is actually start going ahead and upgrading some of these frames here, guys. And I'm going to speed this up because this is probably a boring part. So yeah, when I get all these upgraded, I'll see you guys again. Oh my god, dude, cut that. So we actually got a lot of progress done. Look at this, guys. I might actually try and shape that out a little bit better on top here. Try to get it to match the look of the other house behind it. So yeah, so I try to match that roof behind it. So yeah, without further ado, guys, let's look at this in here. We got that light, nice shining light to come and guide us in. Just got to crouch a little bit right here. And then we can walk right on in. We're going to upgrade these frames later, but I am not going back out for any little bit more wood. So yeah, we actually got a nice little bit of base going for ourselves here right now, guys. So let's go ahead and upgrade these doors as much as we can. And then now we should be good. We should be set to actually go ahead and see what we got going on in our inventory and in our chest. I don't think we're going to be able to actually make it to the city this episode just because we spent so much time. It's already nighttime doing this here. We spent all day looting and we spent all day just fortifying the house and setting things up and just kind of, you know, learning, taking in the learning curve here. So yeah, let's go ahead and see what this actually does. See the functions of this. I never looked at it before. So remove and no more bounds. Okay, so I actually didn't see anything to do outside of the base with the land claim box. I don't know what that is, but let's go ahead and actually put together some of the items that we have here and see what we have. Let's get rid of that broken glass. I can't believe we found 3 junk turrets, AKs, padded armor. We even found that iron mask that I didn't really take notice to because I was just so stunned by the junk turrets and the AKs. So let's go ahead and actually check and see if these take... these take iron armor, like I said earlier. I think they do. Yep, it's just iron. Iron armor. Jesus, it's just iron for ammo. Sorry, not armor. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and place everything that we have in here, guys. So the important items that we have in here, it looks like, is the 3 junk turrets, the padded armor, the 2 wrenches, the AK-47, obviously, the shotgun ammo, the serrated blade mod. Man, we have a lot here, guys. A fucking lot. I believe we actually have... steel spear parts as well, which is actually fucking insane. So this has been a great first episode, man. And I think I might actually call it an episode here after we get everything situated and addressed. So yeah, let's go ahead and organize it. Thank you. And yeah, you guys can have one last quick glance at the inventory and all the loot that we found here for today, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy the episode. I hope I kept it as entertaining as possible. So yeah, there we go, guys. Let's go ahead and have a quick glance through. Look at this shit, guys. We found a fuck ton of shit. So in the next episode, guys, we're going to hit up that city, see what we can loot in there. Actually, I think we're going to try and stick away from a little bit of looting and try and do some more, a little bit creative things. So we spent all episode... looting this episode. So yeah, let me know in the comments what you guys want to see, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you guys for watching. As always, have a great rest of your day and keep it lit. It's been Hates. Peace.